got another confession to make. I'm your fool.
That's just exactly the right kind of tribute for one of the most anticipated books of 2021.
That was good, wasn't it?
What a way to intro.
Really good. Dave Grohl.
Foo Fighters. I'm a fan.
Yeah.
Big fan, in case you didn't notice.
A whole bunch of fangirling and fanboying going on here. The Storyteller by Dave Grohl certainly is one of the most anticipated books. People have been really looking forward to hearing this story. Dave Grohl actually, during lockdown, was writing these great Instagram stories.
Dave's true stories.
So he kept a lot of people entertained and interested, and that prompted him to think, oh, maybe I'd like to write a book, because of course he's a storyteller. His music tells stories, but he's actually a beautiful writer. Much harder than he anticipated, though, to put a book together.
Yeah, he wrote these small stories, as I said, posted on Instagram. He thought, I'm pretty good at this. He did a lot of journaling as a kid, and then obviously music took over, so music was his sort of journaling. His parents are a teacher and a journo, so he's got that knack for it. And what I love about this book, sex, drugs and rock and roll, but without the sex and the drugs. It's more about the rock and roll, this book,
well,
isn't it?
Well, it's more about him and a life. I think, you know, a life most of us could never even imagine. And I really enjoyed also, it felt very personal because he did it. A lot of big name people would just sit down, do a few interviews and then the book would come. It really is from him. And he explains to us how his whole life is kind of punctuated by the memories and the music. So he kind of, a mixtape for young people. If you use a Spotify playlist, it's kind of like we used to make mixtapes where you put all your songs together. And so this book is kind of like a big mixtape of all these little moments from his life. And he really, there's notes that are scratched in as he's written these. He hasn't included just big, sexy, glossy photos of famous people.
Yeah, I love it. And as I said, a lot of handwriting. And the thing, he has lived such a great life, you know. And he goes back, you know, he had his own band, Scream, and then I totally forgot that he was in Nirvana. He was in Nirvana. And then obviously when Nirvana split, Kurt Cobain died, started Foo Fighters. But, you know, a lot of different stories. He said he's got enough content to write probably 10 books. So this is hand-selected parts of his life that are really important to him. But the way that he's written it, it's artistic, it's deep, it's reflective. It's not just like, I went out, I just, you know, took a lot of drugs and had sex with a lot of women or anything like that. It's like, it's authentic. It shows a lot about him. He sort of seems to be the artist or this celebrity that you feel like you could go up and have a chat to him and he would make you feel comfortable.
Yeah, I think he's just a good man, right?
Yeah,
and I think that's one of the reasons people love him. He's a good bloke. He's lived a hard, good life.
He should be an Australian, I reckon. Speaking of which, there is a great chapter on Australia where he got done for DUI.
It's called Down Under DUI.
It involves being at the Gold Coast and a moped. I won't go into too much detail. Well, he did actually get arrested and he's got a criminal conviction in Australia.
But it made a lot of headlines at the time. But it's good to hear it from his perspective, because I remember when it happened and you're like, Dave Grohl, moped, drinking, what? But he tells the story really well.
He loves Australia so much.
Yeah, yeah.
It meant so much to him that he bought a $700 suit for the court case because he wanted to come back here and not get red carded. And the actual ticket cost... The fine cost less than the actual suit itself. So he took it seriously. He went to court in a suit, and now he's allowed back in. Fantastic.
Do you know what's really cool is he's very much a rock star for now, and he is of this generation, but he's spanned, you know, quite a lot of years. But when he tells stories, he's in awe of the people that he's talking about, the Little Richards, the Iggy Pops, the Sir Paul McCartneys. And he tells these great stories about them. There's a lovely piece in here. He talks about getting this phone call, and he's in his mid-20s, from Tom Petty, about can he come and play on Saturday Night Live. And then this beautiful chapter where he talks about being a bit overwhelmed that someone like that would want him. And I loved the line. So this was after Kurt Cobain had passed away. And he was really trying to find what was next for him. And he said, I was too young to fade away, but too old to start again. And I was like, wow, that's kind of, at 25, that's really insightful. And then the decision that he made ultimately about whether or not to play with Tom Petty and what he went on to do. And he just gives us really, he gives us pieces of himself throughout this book, and that's what I really enjoyed. There's a beautiful honesty to it. Yep. He feels like he's talking to me and telling me what's going on. He gives us snapshots of, the rock star world, but also his family life, his folks, his everywhere that he's been. Some fantastic, like, daggy pics.
Yeah, I love the photos because, as you said before, they're not just slapped in the middle, glossy. They combine with the book really, really well, and there's a reason.
There's a chapter about the daddy-daughter dance, and his girls are everything to him, and
there's a big postcard writer back in the day as well, so he's included a few of them. And, you know, interesting thing about those tapes is he used to... because he was a shy kid and he didn't know where he wanted, what he wanted to do and be. So he actually, at night, he would put the tape on and record himself journaling. So that was his first initial part of journaling. He would literally record himself, talk about all his fears in life. And I thought, what kid does that, you know, at a young
Someone
age?
Someone who was like, born to be a storyteller. Now, clearly we're fans. I've seen them a couple of times live. I absolutely love Dave Grohl.
I haven't seen them live yet.
Yeah, it's so good. But, so clearly we were always going to love this book. But I think that any music fan would love this book because of the stories and the way it's told. But I also think it's just a generally, like, here's a good life, a good story. Life well lived. So if you're a Dave Grohl fan, you're giving it 5 out of 5, 6 out of 5. If you don't know him and you're not a massive fan, I think you'll be just fine and you'll still love it. So for the nons, 4.5. If you love him, it's 5.
What are you going to give it then? Are you
5.
5?
Yeah,
obviously.
Five.
Well, I'm a 5, of course. You can't not give it a 5.
That's actually my t-shirt. No, it's my t-shirt. He stole it.
I stink now, so you can't get it back.
It's mine. And just to mention...
What else?
Well, just to mention for the super fans, if you pre-order this book from QBD, you will go into the draw to win a signed drum skin.
Drum skin, super which is something cool. You put around your drum.
Well, you'd actually just frame it and hang it on the wall. Because if you're a crazy drummer, you're going to wear it out.
Would you put it up or would you use it?
Anyway, pre-order it. Yep. You could be a lucky winner.
Decide.